4, negative 1.5 is less than x, less than 1.5. Let f x be the function with the first derivative given by f prime of x equals, okay, that's something. Over which of the following intervals is the graph of f of x concave down? Okay, so first derivative gives you slope. A positive first derivative is a positive slope. A negative first derivative is a negative slope. The second derivative gives you concavity. Positive concavity gives you concave up, and negative concavity gives you concave down. And for those of you that are unfamiliar with concavity is something kind of like, let's say this, where it's kind of goes upward. Let's do a better example. So something like this would be concave up, and the idea is the mnemonic I use is that if it can hold water, rains down this way, water collects in the bottom. Negative concavity would be something like this, where this is the graph, rain comes down this way, flows off the edge, does not hold water. So this would be concave down, this one would be concave up. And so what we're going to do, what it's basically doing is asking us to find the derivative. So, blue will work well. So we're given that f prime of x equals, and I know this looks super complicated, it's not too bad. We can do this. Parentheses minus 2. So then we take the derivative, so f prime prime of x. And this is going to be the chain rule. Chain. So we'll do, so the negative 2, that's just going to go away. And then for here, we're going to have e to the x to the 4th minus 2x squared plus 1 times the derivative of the interior would be 4x cubed minus 4x. And then we're going to set the second derivative equal to 0. And that will give us inflection points. Inflection points are like max and minimums, but for concavity. And so we want to find where the concavity changes, and then we'll find which areas of that concavity are positive or negative. So it's called an inflection point, something like this, where this is concave up, and that is concave down. Okay, so let's find some zeros. Maybe red. Set equal to 0. We know that this will never be 0. E to the 0 is 1. E to the negative infinity is almost 0. It's just really small. But we're limited to x between negative 1.5 and 1.5. So that can never be 0. But this part can be. So we have 4x cubed minus 4x equals 0. So if we divide both sides by x, 4x squared minus 4, we get x can equal 0. And then we get x squared minus 1 equals 0. X squared equals 1. X equals negative 1. And I'll bring the 0 down to show that it's also part of it. 1. Okay, so these are our critical points for determining inflection points for the second derivative. So we're going to look at it like this now. So draw up a chart. So we have negative 1.5, negative 1, 0, 1, 1.5. So I have the negative 1.5s up there because that's our boundary limits. And then I have the negative 1, 0, and 1 because those are our critical points for determining the inflection points. Maybe do something like this. Okay. Too big. There we go. So now we want to find the, we're going to plug in values on basically point here, 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 and here. So four values to find out where the concavity is plus or minus. And we know it's going to change right along these points. So we go back to our equation, the f double prime of x, which will give us our concavity. And the only part of this equation that's going to matter is this portion right there, because we know this side will always be positive. So we want to find out when this section will be either positive or negative. So we don't want to plug in negative 1, 0, and 1, because those are the points times where it changes. That's when this value will equal 0. So we want to do parts on each side of it. So I'm going to choose, let's see here. We'll do 2, negative 1 half, 1 half, and 2. Now you might be thinking 2 is outside of our 1.5 range. That's okay. The concavity doesn't change between 1.5 and 2, even though it's not part of our domain. It'll still give us the concavity in that entire region. So plug in negative 2. So we have 4 times negative 2 to the third, which will be negative 8, minus 4 times negative 2. So this gives us positive 8. This gives us negative 32. Negative 32 minus 8 is less than 0. So this will be negative. Okay, plug in negative 1 half. 4 times negative 1 half to the 8th will be negative 1 8th, minus 4 over 2, minus 4 over negative 2. So that'll be positive. So we have negative 1 half plus 2. So this is positive. Okay, plug in positive 1 half. We have 4 times 1 8th minus 4 times negative 1 half. Positive 1 half. There we go. This gives us 1 half minus 4 over 2, which is 2, which is less than 0. So this is negative. And then we'll plug in 2, maybe up here. Oops. Sorry for all the mess. 4 times 2 squared is 8, or 2 cubed is 8, minus 4 times 2 is 8. So we have 32 minus 8, which is greater than 0. Okay, so now looking at this, we can determine our interval of positive concavity. I don't know why. Probably could have also just thrown this in our calculator. Could have, not worth it. Okay. So, which is the following concave down? So, this region, get good color. Ooh. No, we already have purple. Cyan it is. Okay. So here, so negative 1.5 to negative 1. And then 0 to 1. Oh, so this will be our answer right here. We're concave down, i.e. the concavity is negative. So to recap real quick, we're given a first derivative. We're asked about concavity. So we take the derivative of our first derivative. We now have a second derivative. We set that second derivative equal to 0. It gives us critical points for the first derivative, i.e. it'll tell us where the concavity changes, potentially changes. So we then draw up a table. I like this kind of table for looking at graphs. Put x on top, and then I put f of x, f prime of x, f triple prime of x, or double prime of x. And we really don't care about f of x and f prime of x, because we're all only concerned about concavity. We write up our critical points and put up our endpoints too, just in case. And then we find out, so between these regions, the concavity will be different. And so we test a point in each region. So we used negative 2 to test out past negative 1.5 and 1.5, because 2 is kind of easy to use. It's when you take the third power of 2, you get 8. I then used 1 half and negative 1 half to be between 0 and 1, because 1 half kind of works like 2. So 1 half cubed is 1 8th. It makes it just easy to mathematically do. You could also use your calculator. And then once we found out which regions were negative, we looked up here and, yep, that's where our concavity will be concave down. And that's how you do concavity. That's how you do concavity problems given an f prime of x.